okay. You know, the one question I keep getting asked all the time is like, who makes that hand strap for your Fuji? Where can I buy one? Everybody asks me that question. You can't buy it. I made it myself. It's my own design. And it is a brilliant design, too. Fuji should make something like this. Fuji does have a hand strap, which I do own, but it has several disadvantages, and it doesn't have all the advantages of my design. Oh, yes, I'm very creative. Very creative bastard. Some people are very creative, but then you look at what they create, and you go like, yeah, I can't see anybody wanting that or using it. It's like, well, you're very creative, but it's kind of like some art, abstract art you see in a museum. It's like a mannequin butt that like has a hole drilled in it, and you drop your drink in it, and then like the legs sticking up or like a hat rack. It's like, you know, that's kind of interesting, but I don't think anybody wants one. let's get on to the subject of this topic here. Fujifilm. I repair cameras and lenses. Actually, I repaired two lenses today. One was a Pentacon. I had to take that whole damn thing apart. My God, there was a lot of dried up grease in that old lens. Totally just smooth as a baby's butt covered in Vaseline. I actually had to change baby diapers a little bit. For 2 days a long time ago. Fujifilm. What's so awesome about Fujifilm? This is the best made camera. Now, the Nikon knocked it out of the park. Well, they did, kind of, on the Nikon D500. Well, the D500, as I've said many times in many videos, has a better buffer, much deeper. I mean, it's an XQD card, so, okay? Obviously, it's got better buffer than the X-T2 does. Okay? That's undeniable. Has much better high ISO performance. I mean, ISO 40,000 is incredible. It is also undeniable that Nikon has the huge-ass glass that Fuji does not have. I've got a lot of that huge glass. I mean, I've got friggin' Nikon lenses, you know, falling out of every one of my orifices. But I also own every Fujifilm lens except for two. One of them's the 18mm, which is their worst lens. Worst is a relative term. It's like, well, I love my 18mm. Like, yeah, you do, but it's still their worst lens. And they're 100 to 400. I just don't want that lens. I got no issue with it. I've used it a couple times, but I don't want it. Every other Fujifilm lens I own. Fujifilm is doing a better job, has better customer service, and has better build quality, and has better... Oh my God, you know, people that have been around cameras for a long time, and we know them inside and out, because, you know, I've got at least 30... bodies, dead cameras laying around for pieces and parts that I yank parts off of. Someone would be like, I need a so-and-so part off of an old, you know, it's like, well, I'll see if I got that part. You know, I got buckets of dead Nikons laying around. Someone who fixes cameras and lenses, basically a camera mechanic, if you will, and someone that has been selling them and using them in both photography school and in various camera stores, I can tell you that I've been more impressed with Fujifilm than anything else, and now that Fuji has the X-T20, which is basically like an X-T2 Lite, this without the vertical grip is $1,600. The X-T2 is $900, almost half the price, yet 85 to 90% of what you have in the X-T2. It does have a touch screen, which the Fujifilm X-T2 does not have. I personally don't care about that. If they were actually to add the autofocus feature in the lower left-hand corner like Canon has, that would be a huge boon. It may actually have it with a firmware update. That information is not known yet. But if you have something that's basically 90% of the X-T2, but is also basically half the price, then the X-T20 is going to catch a lot of the fence sitters that were like thinking about snagging a Fuji, and they're going to just push them over the edge into Fuji. And I can tell you this, on the Fujifilm cameras, most of their lenses are made in Japan. Quality of construction, inside and out, is absolutely impeccable. The Japanese-made magnesium chassis X-T2s, like the X100F that's coming out here in less than a month. I already own the X100T. Big Head Taco's already done a review. I like that guy. I don't know why people think I don't like that guy. I've never said it. Big Head. I don't know why he calls himself Big Head Taco, but he's a cool guy. I mean, I think he's a really cool creature. I mean, I basically don't like any of the YouTube photography channels. Some, many of them I do like Ted Vieira, Big Head Taco, Zed Pro Media, Darren Miles, and the other real photographers on YouTube. Those people I like. I don't like any of the gear shills and the gear pimps. I mean, that's no secret. You notice a lot of these people are shooting Fuji. Darren Miles told me that he's looking at, he wants to desperately try out a Fuji. He's just so busy working and other things that he just hasn't crossed over the border yet. But if you're thinking about getting a Fuji, I can tell you this right now, because Fuji doesn't give me a damn thing, that's for sure. That this is, in general speak, unless we're talking about super hardcore sports and wildlife, where you need some huge honking ass glass, or you want the insanely deep buffer where you could just sit there and hold the shutter button down and just let it ream and ream until the card's full, which is capable with the XT, excuse me, with the XQD card system on the Nikon D500 and the next Nikon that's going to come out later this year, because this is Nikon's 100th anniversary. Fujifilm is making the best camera with the best support and firmware updates, and they're the most impressive company. I am 100%, well, I'm not 100% loyal to any company, because that would make me a fanboy. Because I've called Nikon out for stupid crap. Anytime Nikon's done stupid crap, I've called them out. Like their F10, their 105mm lens is a total failure. It's just a crap lens that stupid people are in love with that lens, but I mean, stupid people are everywhere, so there's plenty of people that are going to love that crappy lens. I mean, right after that, they came out with a 70-200 lens, which is insanely expensive. I own it. I gave Nikon endless praise. So I'm not a fanboy for anybody. Not Nikon or Fuji. Yeah, Fuji's made some stupid mistakes that I've mentioned, but this is the most incredible, broad spectrum, best camera company out there by far. They are. And that's from someone with a lot of experience with cameras, a lot. I had a lot of crap pass through my fingers, a lot. So we're talking about incredible build quality, the longevity of the camera, as far as a lot of people build disposable products. It's like you're holding a plastic squeeze toy. It's like the crap's not going to last that long. The linear motors, by the way, just that alone, the linear motors. Now, not all Fujifilm lenses have linear motors in them, but most of them do. Like the 27mm and the 35mm 1.4, those do not have linear motors in them, but they that would be absurd to stick linear motors in tiny little lenses like that anyway. So that's a design. Whoops, that's a design necessity. But as far as the Fujifilm lenses, build quality, internal, external, same as the camera. Absolutely impeccable. I've been so insanely impressed with Fuji. And everybody that was pissing and moaning, the big chirp the past couple of years, like, oh, I would invest in a Fuji system if they had a speed light. Well, now, in this amount of time, Fuji, because Nikon's been cranking out speed lights since the dawn of time, within this amount of time, there are now better options for Fujifilm than there are for Nikon. Not only in price, but in design, ease of use, and yet complexity. See, it's hard to make something both complex and yet very simple to use. I can kind of equate the Fujifilm speed light relative to the Nikon speed light, in that the Fujifilm speed light has all the complexity, yet none of the design ergonomic issues. Like, an iPad is insanely complex, right? It could do a lot of crap. Except you've only got one damn button. Well, you've got a volume button and a power button, but you really only have one damn button on the damn iPad, right? Exactly. And Fujifilm's EFX 500 speed light is exactly like that. Very impressive. You also have the Nissan speed light options, which are full radio control, TTL. Wireless control, endless multiple, not endless, but basically endless speed lights via radio with the Nissan Air Commander. So, my hat's off to Fujifilm. Fujifilm has already announced Amazing Year just 24 hours or so ago. They announced the GFX release, the price. I got a GFX on order. They announced the X100F. I have an X100F on order. I'm not going to get the X-T20 because the X-T20 is just a light version of the X-T2, so obviously I got no damn reason to buy that. However, I will borrow one and fully test drive it for review. So here already before the end of January, you know, Fuji's, you know, Sony and Nikon and Canon, they're not rolling out any medium format crap this year, are they? It's like, who's rolling out the series full-frame camera? Well, medium format is neither fast nor full-frame. I mean, it's a huge honking beast meant for hardcore product and commercial, for hardcore working corporate, commercial, and fashion photography, so on and so forth. That narrow spectrum of use. It's not a general-purpose camera meant to be hauled around. You know, you're not going to haul a medium format camera around and do street photography with it. However, a couple of people have done that on occasion, but I mean, it's obnoxious to even think of doing that. But congrats to Fujifilm. If you're thinking about buying Fujifilm, I have no investment in saying that they are the best currently, and I do have the experience to say that I know more than the rest of the top 20, you know, camera pimps out there that are, you know, flapping their lips about their favorite camera. Because I'm the guy that actually takes this shit apart and knows how it's built on the inside, you know? Yeah, not only that, I've been selling it and using this crap for ages. By crap, I mean a general statement of crap. Yeah, you have to work with the crazy metaphors there. Thanks so much for watching, and if you're thinking about buying a Fuji and you're a fence sitter, then go out and buy one. Hell, you know, if you're in the United States, you got a 30-day return period anyway, so. See, that's what a lot of people do when they don't want to rent a camera. It's like, how much is it to rent that camera? It's a lot of money. It's like, okay, let me buy one. Then I'll return it in a few days. So, I'm not advocating anybody go do that, but that's possible, you know? You feel me? That's why there are a lot of open box cameras. Someone just buys it, and that's kind of like what Best Buy used to do when the Super Bowl was coming. People would buy super huge television sets just so they could watch it for the Super Bowl, and then return it, you know, a couple days later. Yeah. I don't know if you've ever heard of that before. Thanks for watching. Bye. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum.